Welcome back, guys, to another one, and today let's have a look at the brand new all-black sexy new cooler from Noctua, the U9S, specifically made for ITX enclosures. Realistically, as you'll see from the video, this is the only true upgrade for the mighty popular L9A A-series. So, let's see it in action. This Noctua U9S has replaced the U9B series due to its improved asymmetrical design that allows for maximum RAM, case and PCIe compatibility, especially with ITX boards. For a long time, it was the standard for premium single tower 92mm coolers. Today I'm happy to test it in the famous all-new black paint job. It's only $5 more expensive than the regular U9S. Then what I meant by the fact that it's the true upgrade for the L9 series, I'm referring that Noctua has other 92mm options, like the L9X65, which doesn't perform that well over the L9A, for example. The only exception here at 92mm that it's worth mentioning, and it's worth the price, is the D9L that I previously reviewed. Mind you, this is the only dual tower 92mm CPU cooler out there, so it's bound to be excellent. Anyway, the U9S, as the previously reviewed U12S, are in my book ground zero, to which we will rate everything else. As per all of the new Chromax Black Series products, we have the new theme design, thus the presentation is perfect and a joy to explore and read. Take this small eye-catching detail, for example, where the visual depiction of the product is visible on two sides. Then every other side of the box has information regarding to the main highlights of the U9S, the accessory list and the full heatsink and fan specs. Opening, we are greeted with the accessory box that has that famous visual checklist. Speaking of, here are all the accessories laid out. As you can see, the U9S is fully protected from all sides within this cardboard enclosure. Okay guys, just look at it. This is beyond cute and sexy. It measures 125mm tall and 95mm in width and depth with the fan attached, while weighing in total only 618 grams. We have 5 nickel-plated 6mm thick copper heat pipes that hold into place 43 aluminium fins. Then the base plate has an almost mirror polish to it. Then the top plate has the Noctua logo displayed in a subtle engraving, which is surrounded by the ends of the heatpipes. Then from this angle we notice a very aggressive concave fin design, which should improve airflow. Also we have this recess that facilitates access to one of the securing screws, while the hole in the stack of the middle of the fins is for the other bolt. Removing the fan clearly shows the clever offset asymmetrical design of the heatsink. Now the supplied NFA9 PWM Chromax Black fan. I must mention this on every review for Noctua products regarding the SSO2 bearings, which is Noctua's own design. The self-stabilizing all-pressure bearing, hence the name SSO bearing, this system has always been of the heart of their premium products. Basically, it combines oil-based hydrodynamic bearings with additional magnet that supports the self-stabilizing of the rotor axis. SSO2 is thus the further optimization second generation. It's made possible by the use of metal bearing shells, which means that the magnet is now placed on the rotor axis and thus exerts higher magnetic force to it. This results in even better stabilization, precision and durability. My main testing platform is centered around the AM4 socket, but in an ITX format to fully test any RAM compatibility issues, since on this layout all of the components are crammed more together than the larger motherboard formats. Thus the NHU9S should feel right at home. The Noctua Secure Firm 2 mounting platform is also present, and from previous experiences, this is one of the easiest and most straightforward installation sequences ever, especially on the AM4 socket. First things first, make sure you keep the stock AMD backplate after you remove the stock front plastic brackets. Then attach the plastic grey AM4 spacers. Next step involves securing down the metal brackets while making sure that they are facing outwards like so. After the thermal paste is applied, just bolt down the heatsink and that's it. Easy as that. As you can see, there is no clearance issue whatsoever from any angle or corner, and you can have memory modules as tall as you want. Okay, testing time. The CPU is the Ryzen 7 1700, which I will overclock to 3.7 GHz for 1.325 volts. The ambient temperature, as you can see, was pretty cold, so just keep that in mind when you look at the results. As per any other setting, the CPU fan will be left on the standard auto RPM curve to simulate real-life usage patterns, then the side panel for the case will be attached, and the case fans are set at a fixed 30% RPM. Now, here is a quick noise sample in R20. The U9S is marginally louder just from the graph alone, since the single 92mm fan has to spin higher to compensate for the smaller overall fan size, but still, it's a fairly quiet operation as you heard from the clip. In a Cinebench R15 and R20 tests, we see excellent results, barely behind the D9L and some low revving single tower 120mm CPU coolers. Then in ADAS 64 we have the same hierarchy we saw in the previous R20 test. In Rise of the Tomb Raider, we have excellent results overall, since it doesn't push the CPU as much as torture test per se, but still a great indicator of real-life usage. Right then, there you have it guys. It's a very well-known fact that the original U9S is one of the best 92mm single tower CPU coolers out there, and today I just reconfirmed just that, but with a new paint job. It's such an efficient and potent little cooler, given its small footprint, that it's the go-to choice to anybody looking for a heatsink under 130mm that will guarantee zero headaches regarding RAM, VRM and GPU compatibility all around the socket area. This is meant for small form factor machines, so it's understandable that you will not get it to overclock your CPU, despite my great results today even in unusual low ambient temp scenario. But this is a clear upgrade over the stock AMD low tier coolers, and if the space permits, a clear choice over the mighty popular R9A I series. Thank you for watching guys, and see you in the next one. RX out.